My girlfriend wants to kill me. Episode 8. The season finale. A nasty storm was brewing outside of the building as a crash of thunder rumbled in the distance. Love triangle. What in the hell is she talking about, David? Said Misty, as Mary just stood there smirking and wallowing in my humility. And trust me, she was sadistically enjoying every single tormenting second of it. Yeah, what the hell am I talking about, David? Said Mary. Why don't you fill her in and the detective, or shall I? Is this true, David? Asked Misty, her eyebrows rising with each word. Please tell me she's lying. The room fell silent, except for the sound of my racing heartbeat thumping in my chest vigorously. Yes, I said somberly. But this is not about you, me, and my Uncle James love triangle. This is about you murdering him, that cashier, Samantha, her dog Gio, and no telling who else you've killed, you sick, dark, and twisted demon of a woman. Go ahead, keep insulting me. But it still won't change the facts. What facts? I snarled. That you are a psychopath? No, the fact that you knew that cashier. Yeah, that's right. Tell them, David. You were having an affair with her, and I know it. You know nothing, you pathetic, paranoid and delusional woman. I was not having an affair with her. Oh, really? Then what's this? Said Mary, as she reached inside of her pocket and pulled out her cell phone and showed a photograph. What does this look like? Said Mary, her thick eyebrows downward. Looks like a photograph of you and that cashier taking a late night evening stroll through the park, said the detective suspiciously, his untrusting eyes gazing into me deeply. Mind explaining how you knew her? Okay, I did know her, but not in the way that Crazy Mary here's trying to make it seem. I was visiting the store one night, and she had just got off of work. She asked me if I would walk her to her car because she didn't feel safe walking alone. I walked her to her car, watched her get in, then I walked away. That was the last time I would see her alive. Yeah, it was the last time you saw her alive, all right. Because you killed her, said Mary, her eyelashes batting rapidly like the wings of a bat. Just because he walked her to her car like a gentleman is supposed to do, said Misty, defending me, doesn't mean he was having an affair. And it certainly doesn't mean he's a killer. That's right, I said. And you were the one who threatened to go back to that store and cut her tongue out. And later that night, they find her dead with her tongue missing. Is that just a coincidence? She said nothing. She just stood there, her empty, lifeless eyes in deep fixation upon me. "Oh, she's speechless now," said Misty sarcastically. "You shut your filthy mouth, you peasant. I should have both of you arrested for battery since you tried to kill me." "You tried to kill me, you crazy lunatic." "Sounds to me," said the detective, "there's no proof on either side, so until one of you comes up with some sort of evidence against the other, I think we're done here." "You see, David," said Mary, injecting her lies once again, "there's no way I could have killed that cashier. I have an alibi. I was at the coffee house all night, remember?" "She does have a point, Mr. Baker. She was. I showed you the surveillance footage," said the detective in defense of her. "Enough of this! Where the fuck is my uncle?" I yelled. I've never been one to curse or lose my temper the way I did, but this woman had my blood boiling. "I haven't seen your uncle." "Yes, you have. Right before you killed him in his girlfriend's basement. And you probably killed her as well. You have a serial killer standing before you, detective. I suggest that you..." "Let's go, David," said Misty as we walked toward the door to leave. "Oh, I almost forgot," said Mary, with the most evil smile on her face that I so badly wanted to wipe away. "Did you happen to mention to the cops how when you found out about me and your Uncle James and our romantic involvement, you threatened to kill him?" "I could kill him with my bare hands," were your exact words. "Do you deny, Mr. Innocent?" I couldn't take it any longer. I could feel my veins pulsating. "You disrespectful witch! I would never kill my Uncle James. Never!" I yelled as Misty held me back from tearing her from limb to limb. "See, detective? Look at that temper. Oh my goodness, it's almost as if he is capable of murder," said Mary in a whiny tone mixed with her annoying, nasally, trademark giggle. "Wait, is this true?" asked the detective. "Yes, I did say that, but I only made threats out of anger because I was hurt," I replied in shame and regret. "But you did make threats," asked the detective, his eyes narrowing at me with speculation. "Don't say any more, David, without an attorney present." "Let's go," said Misty as she ushered me out of the station. 10 minutes later. "David, why didn't you tell me about the love triangle and you knowing that cashier?" asked Misty, trying to keep her eyes on the road and me. "You can't keep secrets like this from me, David. I'm the one trying to help you expose Crazy Mary. What's this love triangle all about?" "Actually, me and Mary met back in high school. She was a different person back then. We fell in love. After her parents died in a car accident, she became cold and uncaring. I guess that was her way of shutting her feelings off in order to deal with the pain. Long story short, I felt sorry for her. So we rekindled our relationship, only on one condition though. I told her that she had to see a psychiatrist. She agreed. Turns out, her psychiatrist was my Uncle James. She ended up seducing him. It wasn't till later until we found out that our girlfriends were the exact same person. Crazy Mary. Then what? Asked Misty. Shamefully, Uncle James and I were so in love with her, we kept dating her. Then things got really ugly. We started becoming competitive, playing tug of war with her. Then she started pinning us against one another, creating jealousy and hatred. Anyways, me and my Uncle James worked things out, and then we grew close again. Then all of a sudden, Misty's phone rang. She was in deep conversation with whoever it was on the line. Then she hung the phone up. "David, I have the best news in the world," she said with a smile. "That was my friend from New York. He's also a private investigator. He has some evidence against Mary. Something that will expose her. We need to head to the airport right away." On the way to the airport, I had Misty stop off at my car so I could get my gun out of the glove compartment. "It's gone. My gun is gone," I said. "David, we'll worry about that when we get back. We need to hurry to the airport," said Misty. I hopped back into the car as we sped down the road toward the airport. Meanwhile, back at the police station. "Oh my God, you are not going to believe this, Jackson," said Detective Newman. "Believe what?" asked Detective Jackson. "Mr. Baker was right. Mary Slaughter is the killer." "Just look at this," said Detective Newman, as the look of shock shadowed his face. "We need to go arrest her right now," said Detective Newman, as he rose to his feet and sped toward the door. Then all of a sudden, there was a gunshot as Detective Newman fell to the floor with a single gunshot wound to the head. And there stood Detective Jackson with a gun in his hand. He slowly peeled the black leather glove from his hand that he used to pull the trigger, tossed Detective Newman's body in the trunk, drove to the lake, and tossed his body into the water, then drove away. 30 minutes later, Detective Jackson had arrived at a very familiar motel. "Detective Jackson? What a pleasant surprise," said Mary, as her blood-colored lips curved into a mischievous smile. "What brings you out this time of night?" "My partner, Detective Newman, had discovered your little secret, that you are the killer," said the detective. "He was going to expose you. I had to protect you, baby. I can't stay long, though. If anyone sees me here and finds out about me and you being romantically involved, we're in trouble." Say no more, honey, said Mary, as her and Detective Jackson's lips collided into a passionate, dark and twisted kiss. 1 hour later, we had arrived at the airport. Thank you, Misty, for helping me expose Mary for the evil murderer that she is. Finally, justice will be served. You can thank me later when they lock that monster away for good. Let's hurry and get on the plane, said Misty. Then all of a sudden, there was a commotion. I could hear the galloping sounds of footsteps approaching us quickly from behind. Mr. Baker, said Detective Jackson, his eyes scanning me up and down. Yes, I replied. We have a warrant for your arrest for the murders of Diane Fishers, the cashier, your girlfriend, Samantha Shields, your uncle, James Baker, and Detective Brian Newman. You have the right to remain silent. Anything you say, stop this madness right now. He killed no one, said Misty, as they carried me away in handcuffs. To be continued. Stay tuned for My Girlfriend Wants to Kill Me, Season 2.